From a low angle, if I have
I'm not.
Double shut, I'll be back.
Okay, who am I here with today?
Laynie Bliven.
And what grade are you in?
I'm in 12th grade, a senior, and I'm a dance major.
What does senioritis mean to you, Laynie?
Senioritis is such a touchy subject because I feel like I've been in senioritis for 4 years. Senioritis is this to me: pajamas, not coming to school on time. I ditched my first period today, like just being worn out, like not wanting to do anything, not feeling motivated to do anything. Like nothing matters anymore. You just want to get to the graduation. Yeah. That's what senioritis means to me. Okay. Yes, in the past 4 years, yes. And everyone tells me that's impossible, but it's not. I've felt the wrath mostly this year. It's been so hard. Like, I got put in a class I didn't want to. I was in a low dance level. Like, it's just been so hard to keep, like, motivation. So I have, like, so many absences. My grades have not been the best. My GPA has been the lowest, like, it's ever been. So at this point, I'm just trying to graduate.
Okay, how does senioritis set you back?
Senioritis sets me back in a plethora of ways. Senioritis is the thing that makes me not want to get up for school every morning and fight with my mom. Senioritis has stressed me out because I've been wondering whether or not I'm going to have the GPA to even graduate with the cords and all the other things that I want. It just stresses me out a lot. Like, at this point, I've had a hard time in math. I've had a hard time in English. Like, even dance, which is based off of, like, attendance. Like, even that's been hard for me to keep up. It's just really hard to stay motivated when all you want to do is leave. And I guess especially, like, after spring break, when we came back, I feel like we got, like, all a taste of that freedom we're going to have over summer. Like, we're all adults. Oh, my God.
It's okay. I can cut it.
Okay. Like I was saying, we are all adults, and so like we're all driving, we're all with our friends, we all like barely have a curfew, and like that's just gonna be the best over summer. And I feel like it was so hard to have that little taste during spring break and then get knocked back into like your classroom chair on Monday morning. So like I said, my GPA is the lowest it's ever been. Honestly, I wish I would have been a little bit more involved in high school, but at this point, my only goal is to graduate. I don't even care about my GPA, I don't care about my diploma, I just want to get out of here and go live my life.
Okay.
Thus far, my most memorable moment of senior year has been, I know this isn't necessarily like at school, but I remember I had applied to NAU, and that's the only college I applied to. Like I said, my GPA isn't the best, like I don't have the best grades or anything. But so I was so stressed, I just wasn't gonna go to college at all. And like I do have big dreams of like whatever afterwards. But, you know, so anyways, I was clocking out from my helmet and I look at my phone and I get a text message and it says like, welcome to NAU, like you got accepted. And my best friend Emma was going there. So I literally started crying in the bathroom. I was like, I didn't think I was going to college, like blah, 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 blah. And like that just made everything like all the more real to me. Like I'm going to college, I'm graduating, I'm doing like everything I wanted to. Like, you know, you kind of just think about like always like, oh, like even in kindergarten when everyone was like, oh, you're gonna graduate in 2024. So then like the year just keep going and going and going. And now we're in 2024 and it's getting ready to be time to be over.
Okay. And what are your plans for after high school?
After high school, I'm going to NAU with my best friend, Emma. I'm gonna major in criminology and criminal justice. I'm taking a lot of classes surrounding that because I do want to be a criminal defense lawyer. But over the summer, I just plan to spend time with my family, spend time with my friends, and just live summer to the fullest because this is my last summer as a kid and my last summer here in Vegas.
Okay, do you feel ready do you feel ready to graduate?
Yes. Yeah. I'm so sick of driving 40 minutes in the awful I-15 traffic in a more real sense. I'm really gonna miss all my friends. It's crazy to have seen everyone I've grown up with. I've watched everyone turn into adults, and like, I don't even think I'm mentally prepared to watch everyone like walk across the stage and, you know, kind of see everyone accomplish their dreams and go their separate ways. But at the end of the day, this experience with this school was not what I thought it was gonna be at all. for the better and for the worse. To be honest, if I were to do it all again, I don't know if I would come here, but then I think about if I didn't come here, I wouldn't have met my best friend, Emma. So.
Love.
So at the end of the day, I'm ready to graduate, I'm ready for new beginnings, and I'm ready for a new chapter.
Who am I here with today?
I'm Emma Tolbert.
What grade are you in, and what's your major?
I'm a senior, and I'm a dance major.
Okay, Emma, what does senioritis mean to you?
Senioritis to me is a little bit more than just a mindset. I think that as high schoolers, we're kind of told that senioritis is just a mindset and that you can break it super easily, but for a lot of other people, it's a lot more than just that. Like, it's mental capacity and stuff like that.
Okay, have you experienced senioritis, and can you give an example of a time that you've experienced senioritis?
I've experienced senioritis a lot this year. An example of my senioritis could probably be just like my English grade. I had a really hard time at the beginning of the year staying motivated, especially since I didn't really have a teacher, and it was just a harder class for me to get through. I put a lot of stuff on the back burner and then realized about 2 weeks before midterms that I'd have to get my grades up, and that's how it kind of goes every year. So that's an example.
Okay, how has senioritis set you back in your time here?
Senioritis has set me back just in grades in general. Okay, start it over. I don't know what else.
Okay, Emma, how has senioritis set you back in your 4 years here, this year, or any time here at LBA?
I think overall I've experienced maybe an increment of senioritis all throughout my 4 years up until like this year when I kind of got the full effect of it. It's just been a little bit draining, but I think over the course of the last 4 years, I've kind of realized that a lot of it is all in your head and that you can get through a lot of it. Okay, pause it for a second. Also, I think that senioritis has impacted me and my like steps towards college, because towards the beginning of the year is kind of when I started realizing I need to get serious about college admissions and figuring out where I want to go, decision making, that kind of thing. And it's a whole different responsibility going into college, being an incoming freshman. It's literally a whole entire new experience for me. And senioritis just kind of added on to that big mess of work and things to do and just to-do lists that I need to check off.
Okay, what is your plan or your plans for after high school?
After high school, I'm going to be attending Northern Arizona University as a journalism major. It's kind of always been a goal of mine to attend NAU. I had a lot of family go there, and I just love the area. After high school, I will be with my best friend over the summer and be able to spend the next 4 years with her. As well as just achieving some more things that I wanted to achieve over senior year that senioritis got.
Have you achieved, or are you on track to achieve everything that you wanted to over the course of your 4 years here?
I think achieving everything over the course of my 4 years here is somewhat impossible. I have made a lot of accomplishments and done a lot of like notable things that I can be proud of. For example, like I was able to be a part of senior choreography show in the dance department and be able to choreograph a piece on a class that I already love. And that was a really big achievement for me, being able to put my like actual dancing out there. Other than that, over the last 4 years, I graduated. I'm about to graduate. That's the goal.
Okay, thus far, what has your most memorable moment of senior year been?
I think my most memorable moment of senior year was probably senior sunrise. I got to be with all the people I've kind of grown up with in dance for a whole morning, and we kind of just got to skip the first few couple of our classes. It's nice to have a break from just your regular school like schedules. I feel like every day kind of was repeating itself towards the beginning of the year, and senior sunrise was just kind of like an escape for me to be with all the people that I love.
Okay, Emma, are you ready to graduate high school?
I'm so ready to graduate high school. I'm excited to be able to experience more things in the future and be in another state. It's a little bit of a scary mindset to be in, but I'm ready. I'm ready to take on the world.
Thanks, Emma. It actually was.
Okay, who am I here with?
I'm Jude.
Okay, who am I here with today?
Maria.
Alea! What is she on now?
Wait, what?
My hair looks in. You're so pretty.
Oh dear, Alea, it's your souvenir. I wonder if Miss Audis will let us go on stage and get the roses. Yes,
pamphlet, because we.
A face reveal for Reagan.
I don't remember.
I was like,
how did she tell you that? I know that she got as a birthday present.
Yeah, I got she, like, okay, so I got a
bow. I wish to be skinny.
Okay, I got that on video.
Senioritis is whatever you make of it.